Good boy. He leaned back. He thought back. I rewarded that. Don't look for the end product in the first step. I pick up my energy. Attention. Get back. If I were you, I'd be backing up. I can't do that.
I've always
I have
done it in front of me to get him to back, yeah.
No. I want him moving off my body.
Right.
Get back, please. Thank you. Get back, please. Thank you. And then tomorrow I'm going to do more steps a little faster. And then the third day, I'm picking it up. But we have to have it so solid in the beginning before you add speed to anything or distance or anything. So now I'm going to say to him again, here's what I want you to do. I stand, when I want him to go right or left, I stand on the side I want him to go. It kind of blocks him.
Yep.
So I say to him, watch my shoulders. We're going that way. I look at a clock. I'm never going to point to 9 or 3. If I want a hind quarter, the front end to move, and I want the hind quarters to stay still.
Okay.
Because I'll be just dragging them forward,
okay.
And everything's going to move.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say, attention, something's going to happen. We're taking your front end a quarter turn. Moving. Conversation. Miraculously, I'm on this side. Good boy. Good boy. So I want you to shift your weight back, which I just taught you. Shift your weight back. We're going that way. Please. Stuff on the fence, because then the fence helps, so you don't have to explain it so much. You get it good on the fence, then you take it away, and if it goes to crap, you go back to the fence. So I'm not going to do it, but you get the gist of it. So eventually, he'll watch my shoulders. When I ride this horse, here's another thing. When he gets you, you don't realize what he can. If you can see his eye, he can see you. I'm going to let him do whatever he wants. So when I ride him, he's used to my shoulders, right? So it does two things. If you're standing there facing me, right, do this. You're riding. Do this. You're riding. Okay. So now what I want you to do is look up and over. Just use your head. Look at me. I use my whole body. Mm-hmm. What happened when you did that? This leg closed, this leg opened, mm-hmm. right? So if you ride with your body, so I'm teaching this to him on the ground, but more importantly, I'm teaching it to me. So if I want to go, my weight kind of dip, right? Only use your hands as a last resort and then put them together. Don't ride his face, ride his body. So you do it slow and you fool with it, right? See, so when he starts, you think in a Western saddle he can't feel it, but trust me, he can, because it's really kind of weight shifts and
I have done some where I move my body and he will turn, so I have done some of that, yes.
Yeah, so do everything slow and before you add distance or speed, right? These are just a bunch of concepts, so, you know, we can work on But I don't want to work on a specific problem ever. Like, I can tell you right now, he gets hot, he just loses his mind, does his own thing.
Yeah.
He just showed me that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, that's never going to happen when we have good footing and so on and so forth, without consequence. And immediately, two or three times, he'll say, I'm not going there anymore. What do you want?
Mm-hmm.
And that's what happens. They drop their head, they're, you know. Speaking of that, well, I have a lot of videos on this other stuff. I'm not going to bother.
Okay.
What I wanted to do today, like, all right, so I showed you how I would halter him. So when I want to turn him loose, good boy, you're a very good boy. So I rub to the spot, sort of. Sorry, I got that all wet. So now I'm going to say to him, from here on, this is the way we're going to halter and unhalter, bridle and unbridle. Why, you ask? Because if he doesn't tip his nose to me, he can turn and go, kick me, this and that. I want a pattern where he's bent around me so that I'm safe. That's number one. Number two is, good boy, that tasted delicious, didn't it? So when his mouth is like this, his teeth are like this. As he drops his head, look what happens. Horses become hard to bridle for two reasons. People put this side on first, right? Follow him up like that. And then when they put this one on, they go across the eye, hooked it with the buckle and all kinds of shit, and the head flies up, and then they get mad at the horse and all that kind of stuff. There's one reason. Yes. The other reason is, you're banging his teeth. If his teeth aren't like this, and you take that bit out and it's up here, you're banging. How do you like metal banged on your teeth, right? So there's things that we do that create the problems, mm-hmm. right? So this pattern of, and this is a conversation, can you bring your head here? So notice I gave him somewhere to put it. Here's people. Dragging them over. Oh. No, give them a place. This is where I want it. Thank you. Can you put it down? Thank you. Now I'm going to take it off. While it's down there, right? So I take it off. When I take it off, head down.
Reach up then.
So I'm going to ask again. Come over here. Good boy. Head down. Head down. Good boy. Okay, now when I take it off, I do it the same way I put it on. So I'll say, if you drop your head an inch, I'll drop it an inch. You drop an inch, I'll drop an inch. Yeah. Thank you. And then I will walk away from him 100% of the time. Most horses, two, three times like that, they will follow you.
Mm-hmm.
And then they just stay with you. Are we done?
Mm-hmm.
What's up? And blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
Perfect.